وصلي عليه في الآخرين وصلي عليه في كل ملأ وحين اللهم صلي عليه بالملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، الله سبحانه وتعالى told us many many stories in the Quran. And in one of the surahs, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, نحن نقص عليك أحسن القصص. أحسن القصص, the best stories. It's the meaning here is not to tell you the story as a story just we tell. No, the main purpose of the stories in the Quran is to extract the wisdom in the story and to learn and to make decisions based on these stories in your life. Because the stories that have been mentioned in the Quran is actually, when you go in depth, you find it's a life story. A life story meaning that you could, yes, it happens, could be thousands of years. However, the wisdom behind it and the lesson in the story itself is applicable. Applicable all over the way, subhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in this Quran, ضَرَبْنَا فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ نَاسٍ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ. Every example in life you can utilize is in the Quran. And today we will just literally brief, very quickly, we'll go through one of the stories that has been mentioned in the Quran. And it has been mentioned in a way within Surah Al-Baqarah. And it is the longest surah in the Quran. The Surah Al-Baqarah has many, many stories, mainly in the related to Banu Israel, or the descendants or grandsons and grandsons of the Prophet Israel, or Prophet Yaqub, Jacob, who has the two names, Israel and Yaqub. And this is one of the stories that have been mentioned in this surah, and we will learn and extract the messages in this story, because there's many, many messages actually in that story. The story happens after Musa, after Sayyidina Musa, when he already died, he passed away, then the story happens after him. And as you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent, could be thousands and thousands and thousands of prophets and messengers to Banu Israel, one after the other, for all over actually thousands of years, subhanAllah. And that was meant, يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala meant to do that. And Allah mentioned this one, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الْمَلَئِ مِنْ بَنِ إِسْرَائِيلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مُوسَى. After Sayyidina Musa died, and then the people, من الملأ, that means the people who are the authority, the people who could lead the others. إِذْ قَالُوا لِنَبِيٍّ لَهُمْ. So they are now talking to their prophet from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen to the dialogue to tell you what type of people that they are, okay? And how is that people actually, there is a trust between the prophet and them. Listen to the dialogue. إِذْ قَالُوا لِنَبِيٍّ لَهُمْ وَبْعَثْ لَنَا مَلِكًا نُقَاتِلْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. They asked their prophet, okay, send us a king to lead us in a battle, to combat for the sake of Allah. إِبْعَثْ لَنَا مَلِكًا نُقَاتِلْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And then his response is very interesting. He said, إِبْعَثْ لَنَا مَلِكًا نُقَاتِلْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ قَالَ هَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ إِنْ كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ أَلَّا تُقَاتِلُوا. What will happen if the fighting, the battle will be mandated upon you? Are you going to stand for it? A question that tells you he's doubting their message. قَالَ هَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ إِنْ كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ أَلَّا تُقَاتِلُوا. قَالُوا وَمَا لَنَا أَلَّا نُقَاتِلَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَقَدْ أُخْرِجْنَا مِنْ دِيَارِنَا وَأَبْنَائِنَا. As if they are emphasis the point, why not? We've been kicked out of our houses and been, all our children has been actually been kicked out and been lost our belongings and so on. So why not? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just brief it quickly, because the details is going to come later. فَلَمَّا كُتِبَ عَلَيْهُمُ الْقِتَالُ تَوَلَّوا. This is the title of the story, because this is, by the way the Quran a lot of times do this one. If you look at it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you like a title in the beginning, and then the details is coming after. فَلَمَّا كُتِبَ عَلَيْهُمُ الْقِتَالُ تَوَلَّوا إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِنْهُمْ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ. So fighting for the sake of Allah has been mandated upon them. Have they done what they've said they want to do? No. Most of them have not. The details are coming now. So now, what happens? This is the story tells you. When you are serious and sincere with Allah, your words, your action has to be compliant. You have to do what you mean. You have to say what you are willing to say. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in another surah, كَبُرَ مَقْتَنِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَن تَقُولُوا مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. The worst thing, you say something and you do something different. Okay? And this surah and this story is telling you, the people have asked for this, and now the test is coming. Then he told him, the story is continuing now. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ نَبِيُّهُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ بَعَثَ لَكُمْ طَالُوتَ مَلِكًا. Now, you ask it for a king. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send you Talut, who's going to be your leader, the king, who's going to lead you in this battle, because you've asked for it. The sentence is, the message that he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ بَعَثَ لَكُمْ طَالُوتَ مَلِكًا. Allah send you a king. It's not me. When they've asked him, actually listen to the beginning, they've asked the prophet, the messenger himself, اجعل لنا ملكا. They've asked him. He doesn't have the authority. But the answer was, إن الله قد بعث لكم طالوت ملكا. Allah send you a king. Not me. Not the prophet. إن الله قد بعث لكم طالوت ملكا. What was the response? قالوا أن يكون له الملك علينا ونحن أحق بالملك من سبحان الله. You've asked for a king. Now Allah is sending you one, that's Allah. And now they're saying, no, he's not the right person. This is Allah is telling you this. You see where it is? That's why the prophet was doubting from the beginning. Are you really serious? إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ بَعَثَ لَكُمْ طَالُوتَ مَلِكًا قَالُوا أَنَّ يَكُونُ لَهُمْ مُلْكُ عَلَيْنَا وَنَحْنُ أَحَقُّ بِالْمُلْكِ مِنْهِ وَلَمْ يُؤْتَ سَعَةً مِنَ الْمَالِ. He's not that rich. He shouldn't be the king though. Then he told them, it's not about being rich. It's not about money. إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ بَعَثَ لَكُمْ طَالُوتَ مَلِكًا قَالُوا أَنَّ يَكُونُ لَهُمْ مُلْكُ عَلَيْنَا وَنَحْنُ أَحَقُّ بِالْمُلْكِ مِنْهِ وَلَمْ يُؤْتَ سَعَةً مِنَ الْمَالِ قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاهُ عَلَيْكُمْ. Allah selected him. That means no argument. When Allah said this, that means you have to obey. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاهُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَزَادَهُ بَسْطَةً فِي الْعِلْمِ وَالْجِسْمِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him the knowledge, I give him the body to lead, to do the mission. So that means don't argue. It's an order from Allah. You ask for it. And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending you the king that you're asked for. And now we're telling you, no, he's not, because he doesn't have enough money. We are richer. So that means it's all about money here. No, he's more knowledgeable. See, you see, the worst thing, when Allah is ordering something and then you ask it for a justification. When Allah order, you have to obey. Your justification is come second, number two, not number one. You obey first, then you do the research why. Yes, that's good. But do not make your obedience based on understanding why, because you may not even understand. And that's why the Prophet said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاهُ عَلَيْكُمْ. That's his selection. وَزَادَهُ بَسْطَةً فِي الْعِلْمِ وَالْجِسْمِ وَاللَّهُ يُؤْتِي مُلْكَهُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give his kingdom, his authority, his leadership to whoever he wants. Because he knows that this is the right person for you and for the battle that you want. Not only this, look at the next ayah, which gives you how bad these people were. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ نَبِيُّهُمْ. You see, he's still justified why he was selected. Why Talut is selected by Allah. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ نَبِيُّهُمْ إِنَّ آيَةَ مُلْكٍ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ التَّابُوتِ. Aha. Something that they've lost because of their obedience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left with Sayyidina Musa and Sayyidina Harun a lot of tokens, a lot of things that actually, when you read it, very interesting, makes the blessing for them. But because they disobey Allah, they've lost it. All of these tokens lost, and they know these tokens, these are the ones that makes a lot of blessing for us when we have it, inherited from Prophet Musa and Prophet Harun. And they've lost it. And he told them, ayat al-mulki, the proof that he is the king, the one that deserves to be the leader, and يَأْتِيَكُمُ التَّابُوتِ, he is going to get it back. فيه سكينة من ربكم وبقية مما ترك آل موسى وآل هارون تحمله الملائكة. He's going to get you back all of these tokens that he's lost them, because he knows how to do the job. And all of this, and فيه سكينة من ربكم, subhanAllah, all of these tokens has come, when you have it, you have the content. SubhanAllah, فيه سكينة من ربكم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them a lot of things which is tangible. SubhanAllah, يعني, when we want هذه سكينة or content or satisfaction, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we do dua. Allah give them physical items, tokens. When they have it, they have that. SubhanAllah. فيه سكينة من ربكم وبقية مما ترك آل موسى وآل هارون تحمله الملائكة. Angels will be carrying them back to you. إن في ذلك لآية لكم إن كنتم مؤمنين. This is a proof from Allah that He is the person that deserves to be the leader. Don't challenge this. It's an order from Allah. That part of the story tells you sincerity that plays huge, big part of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your heart plays a huge role. It's not about your physical movement. And that's why we always say there's a big difference between being a Muslim. That means you do the salah and siyam and zakah, which is a'mal al-jawarih, actions that you have to do. That's different than your heart, the belief, the trust in Allah. المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. This is the definition that is mentioned in Surah Al-Anfal. Who are the believers? Five things mentioned in the definition. First three of them is all about the heart. إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم. When Allah is mentioned, or Allah is ordered, وجل القلب, you shake your heart, touches your heart. Because it's words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. When the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recited upon them, it increases their faith. Because it's directly linked to their heart. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. Because التوكل على الله, that means you completely depend on Allah. You do what you have to do, but you accept the results from Allah. And that means you have the full trust. First three criteria of a believer. Then follow. الَّذِينَ يَقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Look at the sequence. The first three is only for the heart. And then the two actions after is your actions. الصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ. The story is here. The sincerity for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't say I'm going to do X, Y, Z. And at the time of commitment, you don't. It's extremely important, your sincerity. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you your reward based on the sincerity, not based on how big is the action. Okay? What does that mean? Okay, I'll tell you just physical example. When you, for example, donate £1,000 and someone donate £10, well, according to the calculation, he's going to make more thawab than you. The reality is not. The reality is not. Because at the time when you have paid the 1,000 and the time when you have paid the 10, what was your intention? And what was your sincerity? Huge hidden factor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who knows about it. Angels only write down the actions. Keep that in mind. Only write down your actions. They don't know your intention. The intention is only for Allah. And that's why the shaitan can disturb your action, but he can disturb your intention. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it hidden. Even shaitan doesn't know about it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will evaluate and give you the rewards based on your intention at the time when you've done the action. This is a critical thing for you as a Muslim to understand. Okay, sincerity is a key thing. We will continue, inshallah, the rest of the story in the second part of the khutbah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى اليمين والشمال مضلة طريق الوسطى هي الجادة عليها ذات الكتاب ومنبر السنة هلك من ادعى وخاب من افترى وهلك أعداؤنا وأعداء الله. The story still continues. And those people who said that we want the battle for Allah and we want to do this for Allah and all of these good words at the beginning. فَلَمَّا فَصَلَ طَالُوتُ بِالْجُنُودِ فَصَلَ طَالُوتُ means now he's taking all everybody because they said we want to go through the battle. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test them. Because sincerity, always, keep that in mind, always tested in the test. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us. Okay? يُمَحِّصَ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَيَمْحَقَ الْكَافِرِينَ كلمة يُمَحِّصَ what does mean? Yani imagine like we are going through a filter. A filter. Who's gonna pass? Who's gonna fail? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of us, is going through huge tribulation. فَلَمَّا فَصَلَ طَالُوتُ بِالْجُنُودِ and this is exactly the example. قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مُبْتَلِيكُمْ بِنَهَرٍ it's very hot, and you read the story in details, extremely hot. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to test them. There will be a river. A river. فَلَمَّا فَصَلَ طَالُوتُ بِالْجُنُودِ قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مُبْتَلِيكُمْ بِنَهَرٍ فَمَنْ شَرِبَ مِنْهُ فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي despite all the temperature and the heat and all of that, if you drink, you're out. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَطْعَمُهُ فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي who's not going to drink, he's one of me. إِلَّا مَنْ يَطْرَفَ غُرْفَةً بِيَدِ غُرْفَةً that means just that, a sip, as we said in English, a little sip. That's it. Sip, غُرْفَة, once. Not two, not once. Subhanallah. So the order and the test is completely against your will. That's always ibtila' in Allah. Ibtila' is always against your will. Subhanallah. And that's why a lesson to learn here. One of the great scholars has been asked, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, ibtila' is been for two main purposes. Could be ibtila' because of, or bala' because of our sins, and could be because we are good. Then if you look at the life of all the prophets and all the messengers, every one of them has gone through ibtila. طيب, is it ibtila or bala? Because the difference is, the bala, that means it's a really bad thing, it's a punishment. Wabtila, that's a test. How would I know? Listen to the answer, because the answer is telling you. Very interesting answer. It's all about your reaction. إِنْ اِبْتَلَاكَ اللَّهُ وَغَضُبْتْ فَهُوَ عَقَابْ And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give you a tribulation in this way, I mean, you are angry, you don't agree with this. You are completely in denial. What does that mean? It's a punishment. Because you are completely in denial. إِذَا غَضِبَ الْعَبْدُ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ بَلَاءٌ وَإِذَا صَبَرَ الْعَبْدُ فَهِيَ كَفَّارَةٌ If you are going to be patient, patient, because now you understand this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was meant to happen to me. You are patient. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to happen to me. Then it's kafara. Kafara means what? Kafara means that it literally nullify all your sins. Subhanallah. وَإِنْ رَضِيْتْ فَهِيَ ارْتِقَاءٌ If you are going to not only to be patient, no, you are satisfied, content. You got to the level where you are content. Allah's kimmat irtiqa means you are going to be promoted. Promoted. Because you've not only accepted what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was meant to happen to you, but you accepted to the limit where you are satisfied with it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want this to happen to me? Alhamdulillah. A very interesting. So based on your response, your reaction to the tribulation, what it means to you, that's exactly. The story is, they have been tested, a river. And what happens? فَشَرِبُوا مِنْهُ Most of them drink, إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِنْهُ Very little number of people who who just either never drink anything or just a sip, as he said. فَمَنْ شَرِبَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ لَيْسَ مِنِّي وَمَنْ يَبَشَرُهُ فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي إِلَّا مَنْ اغْتَرَفَ غُرْفَةً بِيَدِي فَشَرِبُ مِنْهِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِنْهُ. Very little number who stand for it. Always the order and the ابتلاء from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always against what you are, what you love to do. Simple example that we all know, fasting in Ramadan. Is it something that you really want to stop yourself from eating and drinking and all of that? No. It's completely against your desire. That's exactly it. That's exactly it. Every ibtila that we are going through, financially, socially, whatever it is, it's completely against what we want. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing, what is your response to this one? How are you going to react? Okay? And they've already, most of them haven't. And then when they stand for the battle, even those little number of people, قَالُوا لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا الْيَوْمَ بِجَالُوتَ وَجِنُودِ. Yani we cannot stand then against these guys, they are extremely strong. قَالُوا لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا الْيَوْمَ بِجَالُوتَ وَجِنُودِ. قَالَ الَّذِينَ يَظُنُّونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُلَاقُوا اللَّهِ. There has been a very little number of people that knows that we are here to battle and die for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of them was Sayyidina Dawood. That's how the Prophet Dawood started. قَالَ الَّذِينَ يَظُنُّونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُلَاقُوا اللَّهِ كَمْ مِنْ فِئَةٍ قَلِيلَةٍ غَلَبَتْ فِئَةً كَثِيرَةً بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. A lot of times, the battle for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not about how many people, it's about your sincerity. How sincere you are, that's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالنَّصْر دَئِمًا. When you read the whole Quran, وَالنَّصْر إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. The victory only comes from Allah, not because you have the technology, or you have, no. It's all about sincerity. Listen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us another ayah. وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا. Aha. وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُقِنُونَ. So that's the reason. جَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً. We made them leaders. جَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَأْتُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا. When did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them that promotion? لَمَّا صَبَرُوا. When they have been already gone through ابتلاء and they've been extremely patient. وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا لَا يُقِنُونَ. When they come to the limit where they have no doubt in terms of faith, that's how victory happens. A very clear scenario Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us. Then, وَقَتَلَ دَاوُودُ جَالُوتَ. Ah, that's where Sayyidina Dawood, or David in English, come to the picture. That was the first step for him. He was the one who killed their leader, Sayyidina Dawood. وَقَتَلَ دَاوُودُ جَالُوتَ وَآتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ. Now he became the messenger. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him not to be only a prophet or a messenger, no, a king. And Allah gave him the wisdom, الْمُلْكَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَعَلَّمَهُ مِمَّا يَشَاءُ. But the ayah is telling you, فَهَزَمُوهُمْ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. Well, there's a big difference I want to tell all of you. There's a big difference between when you say insha'Allah and bi'ithnillah. There's a big difference between the two. Then don't mix the meaning. Okay? Insha'Allah, it's something that you are going to do something, and then you say insha'Allah, I'll meet you tomorrow, insha'Allah. I will pass the exam, insha'Allah. And that means I have to do something. Something that I have to do. And then based on what I'm going to accept, with the willing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the results. That's how insha'Allah is used. Bi'idhnillah is only something for only Allah to do, not for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in shafa'ah, for example, وَكَمْ مِنْ مَلَكٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ لَتُغْنِي شَفَاعَتُهُمْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ أَنْ يَأْذَنَ اللَّهُ يَأْذَنْ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَرْضَى. إذن الشَّفَاعَةَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. دخول الجنة يدخلون الجنة بإذن الله. يعني don't think your good actions or whatever you've done in dunya that will take you to Jannah. No. probably would say that, then why I'm going to do it? Because your degree in Jannah is based on what you've done. Like in the whole in Jannah, entry of Jannah is Ibn Allah. There's a big difference. There's one thing is to get in, and that's which level that you are. Which level you are is how good have you been in dunya. Like in the whole in Jannah, entry of Jannah, bi Ibn Allah. SubhanAllah. Okay? The story is telling us many, many things. One, sincerity. Two, obedience to Allah. Three, don't argue with Allah's order. Don't ask why. Obey Allah first, then do the research second. Four, when you have gone through ibtila, accept it. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to happen to me. Alhamdulillah. I'll accept this one. Then you will find the results is great after this. Accept the tribulation that you are. And understand it's a tribulation. It was meant to happen to me. Or to the community, or to the society, whatever it is. Accept it and say Alhamdulillah. A lot of messages in this story that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us a lot of things that we have to change in our day-to-day life. The story happens thousands and literally more than 2,000 years ago. But still the lessons in this story is applicable to us. Because it's all about the relation between us individually and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And where is your sincerity stands? Big difference. When you are sincere to Allah, big difference is going to happen. I hope, because this is a very quick through the story, to be honest. There's a lot of details, interesting details, but I can't do it because of the time. But at least the main messages and the main lessons and the wisdom in the story is clear for all of us to enable us to do the change and to be really sincere with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's how we make the victory. Victory never happens unless you are going through patience and going through really difficult time and accept it. SubhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end could do whatever He wants. He is just testing you and I. Do you really deserve Jannah? That's the one, I don't know how many million question, important question, if we call it like $1 million question or £1 million question. Do we really deserve Jannah? And that's the question. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making you and I go through tribulation, that means Allah is testing you. Do you really deserve it? Are you going to be patient? Are you going to satisfy, accept it, and not to be in denial? That's the main message. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم اللهم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم ارحمنا فأنت بنا راحم ولا تعذبنا فأنت علينا قادر واطلب بنا يا مولانا فيما جرت به المقادير ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير اللهم اغفر لنا الذنوب واستر لنا العيوب وارحمنا برحمتك يا كريم يا رب العالمين اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك وأكرم الأكرمين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم يا رب العالمين اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما وتفرقنا تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ضالا ولا محروما ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم يا رب العالمين أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك وأنت أكرم الأكرمين يا رب العالمين ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير اللهم آخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلي وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد عدد ما يرضيه وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا